Are you into affordable cases with RGB fans? If so, stick around for this video where I'm going to be looking at Raid Max's neon case. What's going on everybody, my name is Crimson and today I'm going to be looking at one of Raid Max's most affordable cases with RGB in it and determining whether it's worth the $50 that it sells for. Starting off from the outside, you might not be able to see it right away, but the front and side panels are both acrylic and not glass. Even though I'm not a fan of acrylic anything, I can definitely say that moving this computer around is super easy because it doesn't weigh anything since there aren't any heavy glass panels on it. Moving over to the inside of the case, the first thing you might notice is that there isn't an exhaust fan for some odd reason, and even weirder is that the exhaust fan slot that is available in the back is for 80mm fans and not 120mm fans. Now while we're talking about this, it does have 3 pre-installed fans that are located in the front that connect over Molex, meaning that you won't be able to control the speed of the fans, but it is a nice addition to the case. Now something I didn't like about this case was the building process. I've built over 100 computers and this case is up there for the top 5 most complicated cases to work in because there simply isn't enough open slots for me to put cables through in order to keep the cable management optimal. In case you didn't see it, there's a huge cable running by the top of my motherboard because there wasn't any other way to get the cable to that location without resorting to the only open slot, which is on the right side of the motherboard, so it had to drag across. Now don't get me wrong, I don't think this case is the worst case ever, but it's definitely not anywhere near a great case. I do certainly think that there are a lot of things that Raid Max could do in order to make this case a lot better, simply by adding more space for fans to get air from, and simply by adding an exhaust fan opening slot that's bigger than 80mm because no one really has a little fan around. Now another thing to keep in mind is that this case definitely isn't for everyone, because for people like me that have a very high functioning system that has a GTX 1060 and you know Ryzen 5 1600, all of these overclocked, it's gonna get a little toasty inside of the case. On the other hand, if you have a lower end system, maybe an i5-2400, you know, something a little bit older with a GTX 1050 in there that's running the power through the motherboard, this case might be really good because it's a, you know, reasonably affordable case and it's gonna look pretty. Now, I'm not trying to bash on Raid Max. I've used a lot of Raid Max cases and I know that for a fact that they make awesome cases, and in fact, my favorite case of this day is a Raid Max Sigma because it just looked so good and it just felt really well built and it was the easiest case to work inside of. I just think that Raid Max got caught up on the RGB hype and came up with something quick and at an okay price, but they didn't really test the longevity of it, and just, you know, for typical users like me that have a little bit of a higher end system, I can already tell like how this case is going to affect me. Anyways guys, thank you guys so much for sticking around for this review of the Raid Max Neon. Let me know what you guys thought of it by dropping a like if you enjoyed and subscribing if you want to see more content like this. If you guys want to talk to me, I suggest you guys follow my Twitter and check out my Discord. They will both be linked down below. And also let me know what you guys prefer, acrylic or glass. I had this discussion with a few people and we just couldn't find common ground. I like glass panels a lot more. I like the quality of glass panels. They personally have never broken on me, and I've actually dropped cases and the glass has never shattered. So just let me know if you guys like the acrylic or the glass. Anyways guys, have a great day and I will catch you guys next time. Peace guys.